And this project was super interesting because basically Zanotta, that I don't know if you know, it's an Italian furniture distributor. They allow us to take their catalog and choose pieces from the whole catalog. Pieces that have 50 years of history, Cacignani pieces, everything we want was like the perfect project. Everything we wanted we could do.
All those authors who study up in the book.
Yeah. I had to study them because I never heard about all of them, so I really had to do some study work myself, but they helped, of course. And you can move on because I'm like talking about them.
Basically what they asked us, we took the Zanotta catalog, we had a look, and we were allowed to choose whatever piece, and the idea was to ask, to give one piece of the catalog to each comrade of our team. And the proposal was to customize this piece and invent a new story, a new perception of it. So a new object that maybe was yes connected to the shape of the old one being the classic Zanotta piece, but at the same time that was that gave a message that was totally different, so a different perception of this body. For example, those are three objects we took from the catalog, and this is the result. The table became a birdcage, the Shanghai became a bench of tools, and the venue, the perfect venue's body became a fat venue. So this is actually
So Valentina did the bird cage, which was a beautiful object. And me, I was really scared, I must say, because I had been in because first I was a student before working at Senior Center as well. And it was maybe the first time I had to directly deal with product design and also production, because after we had to do something that was feasible, we couldn't dream really high because in the end the product has to be easily made. So for me it was very scary to start working with product, and in the end I think it worked out quite well. And for me this Venice mirror was something I didn't understand. It was like something that I thought it was I thought it was a very mysterious, weird piece to have at home. So I decided to.
But actually, I think I always said to Katarina, even if she's a graphic designer, but in this project, the graphic approach was really good as an approach, because this Venus body is the perfect woman body, and she worked on the semiotics, so she worked on the communication of the shape, and maybe in this kind of your knowledge is
a nice balance between everyone.
So these are the samples, the table and the famous long chair. They become those objects. So under the table becomes under the table. So they use these laser cut sheets to build an imaginary life under the table, and the chair becomes an animal with handmade sketches. This is a quaderna became a picnic table and a shower, inspired by the strange gesture that the table had. And again, the event, the idea of having a huge logo, the graphic.
The logo was made by all the objects we used, all the objects we transformed, so you can see that we just made them into letters.
And the event and the possibility we had to meet the designer of the beginning objects. So for example, Jade met...
Jade is a 21-year-old girl that we mentioned.
Yeah, she's very young. Jade met Paloma, who was the designer of this chair, and they were having a drink together. And the good thing is that the designer really liked the Imaginara, this is also.
Yeah, this is my graphic.
Imaginara, I will talk about it. It's an installation we did for a furniture fair. We were inspired by those ceramics, typically Portuguese. This partners that were trying to repeat exactly the nature. So they were plates, the shape of leaves,
cabbages,
boxes that look like pumpkins. And we were inspired by this attempt to reach perfection of nature. And we work on the opposite side. At the beginning, we work on the imperfection, so putting holes. This was an installation for the from the furniture fair of 2008. And it was a kind of a green space where we were supposed to grow vegetables not perfect. And this imperfection was created a perfection because from the defect sometimes we have the beauty. So it was a thought between beauty, defect, and nature. And after it was developed and the project was enriched by the use of technology, and we did an installation with cables
and screens.
And screens. This is the exhibition went to Tours Gallery in Paris, and the most famous exhibition went to the museum in New York, where screens were connected with the surroundings with cables, and we were showing this interactive project where it was a clock made by screens, and each number of this clock was made by vegetable, and actually the image was able to be replaced by a customer from home. If he was looking at a zucchini, thinking about a number one, he could shoot the zucchini, upload it to the website, and it will appear on the screens at the museum. So
life, everything life.
Yeah. It was an installation about interactive technology, nature, and design.
And also we worked with these producers in Italy, this small factory that I don't know if you can see, but they did this amazing. So I designed this illustration that you see in the first slide of my special. And after we embroidered in this silver string.
Yeah.
Yeah. This, what was it, like 9 meters? Yeah. They were huge. And so we worked together with the ladies from this small factory. It was very interesting in how to produce this table cloth and what was the best way.
So a graphic became an object.
Yes.
Escobar, now we talk and we see some projects, some very recent projects. Escobar is a project we show in the last furniture fair, so last April 2011. And this was a research project. Everything started from this structure, this very strange structure that one of the guys working with us found in Scotland. He's a Scottish guy, he's in Brown. And he found this in a second-hand market where they were selling vintage objects. This was apparently a structure that was made by fishermen, and so they could cover themselves by fishing in rainy days. And what happens to this structure is that we build 10 of those structures, and we gave one to each company of our team. And each of us had to customize the space and create the space. This is one example. They were proposing a meeting space, so we produced bench, starting planning to have this meeting area. After, do you want to talk about
me? Mine was a bit special because actually they were working in pairs. I was not here, I was working so far when I was in New York, and Sam challenged me to, I didn't have a pair, I was the only one left with no one. So I worked with the sponsor, many times we have sponsors for the event, so we worked with a sponsor called Mio Netto, which is a Prosecco producer from Venice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And they wanted to talk, I asked them, okay, so if I work with you, what do you want me to use? And they said, okay, we have this new project called Spritz, so it's like the typical Spritz cocktail, but in a bottle. And so I used all their bottles, and I created this font. It was kind of a cocktail of letters as well. It was a letter soup, and you could see spelled in the installation the recipe for Spritz. This was the idea.
After we had my installation was the top right one, I was talking about the storm and nature using a photograph from Gustavo. So we were collaborating together. Gustavo again is our photographer, and we did this installation, and this was a photograph taking a bad thunderstorm in the nature close to here in Treviso. And we built those objects as, and we wanted to propose a picnic in the nature after a thunderstorm. So the idea was to have an impossible picnic, but actually you don't, you are not wet, so it's safe. The fire is an electric fire, so you don't burn. There's no wind that makes your hair a bit untidy. So it was a kind of ironical statement. But a nice project I want to talk about is in particular this mobile museum, made by two of the people of our team, a graphic and a designer. And I want to talk about this mobile museum because it was the excuse, the general project we gave to the team was for them an excuse to start a personal project again. Personal projects are welcome. When a person proposes their own project, we evaluate, some they are better evaluate, and if we think it's a good team